Right now we found out that condenser assembly need to be removed. Condenser assembly is mounted on a huge amount of 10 millimeter bolts. This is one of them, this is the second. Remove all of those bolts using 10 millimeter socket. As well, you can notice that even the headlights are connected together with it. So maybe even removal of headlights is needed. We will figure it out.
Yeah,
removal of the headlights is needed because assembly headlight is mounted on top of condenser assembly. There is no way how you can remove condenser assembly without being removing the headlight units. The headlight is mounted 10 millimeter, and another 10 millimeter is here. Also, don't forget to disconnect electrical connector by tapping on top of the electrical mounting, and he will be out of your way. Remove the last 10 millimeter bolt. When the last 10 millimeter bolt is removed, the headlight unit is out of your way. And of course, underneath of the headlight unit, there is one more bolt, additional bolt, which is attaching the condenser assembly to the body of the vehicle. Removing the second headlight, the same steps basically. Disconnecting the electrical connector. Disconnected. And the headlight unit is out of your way. Put all screw together. At this step, when all those units removed, we can see that the assembly of this condenser is almost out. This bolt need to be removed. This bolt need to be removed so far. Maybe there is additional bolts. It will take us a while.
We have 12 millimeter socket. Let's go ahead and break it.
Using the breaker, not a ratchet. Because the ratchet you can break. You need to use a breaker bar to make it loose.
Okay. We see it.
Right now you have to disconnect the low pressure line and high pressure line at this step to free condenser out. We're using the 10 millimeter socket. 10 millimeter socket we're using because there is two bolts on a low pressure line and high pressure line. The first bolt is loose. This was a high pressure line. This is actually the lines which are bringing freon to condenser itself.
This is disconnection line.
Alright, right here we decided that we don't want to drain the coolant, that's why we will just try to put the condenser assembly on top. And to do this, you need to disconnect the wire harness. Ah, no, actually the hose is here.
The hose.
Disconnect all the electrics, lines.
Yes, we decided that without been draining the coolant, you cannot do this labor. That's why the whole assembly need to be taken out. There is one hose which is bringing coolant to the radiator here, and another hose is on the other side. Before you will disconnect those hoses, you need to prepare the drain pan if you want to catch up all coolant.
Alright,
this need to be removed as well, which is holding the hood on place using two 10 millimeter bolts.
To remove this, you just twist your fingers, you take out ball.
Then you see how it's going through. Just remove it.
Just 1 second.
Just firstly remove the whole assembly out from your way and put it a little bit upper. It'll be easier for you. When the assembly will be upper, holding on to 10 millimeters, as we mentioned before, you will be able to put this lock upper. You will be able to disengage it out more easily. There is a ball. Simple as this. And you will be able to remove this out. But not now, a little bit later.
Yeah.
You have to disconnect this assembly, which is making your hood to be opened. But to remove this, you have to put this up, and then you have to press in a small tip, and it will be out. This connector was a little bit complicated when he mounted on this radiator sensor. You have to use a very, very small flat screwdriver, and you have simply tap over here. When you tap over here, you can pull him out. We almost made all wire harness free. Right now it's time to drain the coolant and by disconnecting the coolant hoses. This hose is bringing air to the throw plate. Very complicated piece. Basically it's holding all wire harness on top of him. You can remove him out from your way. He's mounted here. You're removing him out from your way. You don't need him.
We're sucking air from this and bring it to the throw plate.
You have to disconnect electrical connector from the fan. This one. Disconnect him by tapping here with a flat screwdriver or with the fingertips. The finger will fit here. When you all done and you disconnected all grounding points and you made sure that it's free on the right side, nothing, there is only hose left. Position the drain pan underneath. We don't have bigger size of the pan, but it will catch most of the fluid. And you need to remove the clamp using these pliers. Firstly, you have to put the ring up. To squeeze it easily up, spray it with D40. You will be able to put him up.
Firstly, you need to do it.
Yeah, you need to use big pliers here, and the ring is up. We was trying to use the small one.
The small one.
And we was trying to use this one. It was very, very hard to access. The big one did the labor perfect. Okay, using the long flat screwdriver, you start disconnecting the hose. Try to catch more fluid as possible, because if you don't want to buy the new one. When we disconnected the coolant hose, we also noticed that we need to disconnect here. It's bringing some vacuum to the radiator. Use the pliers, put the ring up, and simply remove it. Okay, we did lose some coolant, maybe like 300 milliliters, but it's not that bad. But condenser assembly is out. Is out. As soon as we disconnected the second hose, the condenser assembly is removed. This is the condenser assembly. Right now we have to remove the actual condenser itself and match it with the replacement part, which we ordered on eBay. After making some observation, this is for sure that you cannot replace condenser without being removing the radiator. First of all, you have to remove the radiator from this side, and then you have to extract condenser. You cannot extract condenser from this side because there is no way how you actually can do it. Condenser itself is mounted to the radiator. When you will remove radiator, condenser will go together with the radiator out.
Okay. So you need to put all three fingers in there and just push them as hard as you can.
Just take your time, don't break
it. Yeah. Lose a little bit. Twist it. And then it will release. Here we go.
Take your time on this step, it takes time. And here strength of the fingertips.
Yeah.
Two of them are removed from both sides.
You need to make sure that FR, this arrow going on front, on you, on the car, on your insulator back. Removed. Whole unit.
When you remove those two on top, you can easily remove the whole radiator. You can squeeze him out together with condenser. Then you have to remove this bolt. Don't be try to use the screwdriver, the thread will be gone. You have to use 10 millimeter socket, put on top, and you will be able to remove this bolt out. Okay, you have to press with the fingers down, you press them down, and then you can remove the condenser out from the radiator assembly. The new replacement came with these bolts. It's plugging the entrance. It's protecting it. Use this screwdriver to remove them. When you removed, you need to remove the seals, the high pressure line and the low pressure line. This is a new condenser. We tried a low pressure line fits perfectly and the high pressure line fits perfectly. We plugged low pressure, this is old condenser, this is new condenser. We tried, low pressure line matched, high pressure line matched. As you can see, the shape of the entrance a little bit different, but the size absolutely identical. Also, the second difference, we noticed that the condenser is, let's say that it could be orifice tube, or it could be expansion well, or it looks like it's just an AC filter. This one filter is located on the original part right here, so basically it's right here, but on the replacement part, it's located from the other side. But I don't think that it's a big deal, because the size of original condenser and the replacement is absolutely identical. The size totally matches. Installing the new condenser to the assembly. You're doing it like this. You have to make sure that you match the locks. Okay, the new condenser is successfully installed to the radiator assembly. Okay, we put the assembly back. Radiator and condenser we put back to the assembly. Make sure that this matched and this matched everywhere. Everything is inside. We can start installing these locks.